Hello everyone, today in this video I will be discussing about the numericals of ADE module 1. So the numericals which are asked in exam come among these, any of these, and we are going to discuss all the examples, one or two examples from each of these topic. And I hope so, if you watch this carefully and get the concepts of how to solve the numerical, it would be sufficient for you in exam, and the things will be easier for you when you write the exams. So let's get started now with the first one, which is BJT. So for BJT I have taken one example. The formulas are there for different types of BJT, slight different formulas, but the things are same. We have to calculate IB, IC and VCA. I had told in the previous video that we have to concentrate on VCA, IC and IB for the numerical part in BJT. So let's see how we can find out. So what they have given, first write out VCC 18 volts, RB 470 kilo ohm, RC 2.2 kilo ohm. VBE actually they don't give, but actually if they don't give anything, take as default 0.7 because it's for silicon, 0.7. If it's for germanium, I hope so they will specify that it's for germanium 0.3, okay? If they don't give anything, take as 0.7. I've seen in the examples, in all questions they have taken as 0.7. And what we need to find, for any question, just write the given, and to find the question becomes simpler. You can easily calculate then. Just write the given to find what, then write the formula for each of this and apply the values. That's it. For all numericals, you have to follow these simple steps, then the things will be very, very, very easy. Okay, and this beta here is almost 100, every time it's 100 until they specify it. Beta means the gain in the IC due to the IB, okay? That is 100 most of the times, but yeah, if they don't give anything, you can take it as 100, it's all right. Okay, so after filling the values, we get the answers, and that's it, the question is over. And we have to do like this for the base bias, if they give, or the collector bias, or the voltage divider bias. This, the formulas are a little bit different. You have to use and apply the same things. Just concentrate on IB, IC and VCE. Coming to the monostable multivibrator, many questions have these things only which they give T, R, and we have to calculate the capacitor value, or they will give the capacitor value and we have to find out the R, and T will be given, and such things will be there, but the questions revolve around these three values only. So this is the main formula which you need to remember for a monostable, only monostable, okay? So after fulfilling the values in it, we get the C value very easily, and that's most of the questions which are asked for multi vibrator in the under the topic monostable multi vibrator is this type only. You can find out easily. This is the blueprint of what type of question they ask, and similar slight differences will be there. That's it. Next, coming to the A-stable multivibrator, things are a bit complicated, but it's still easier, it's not that hard. So in A-stable multivibrator, they will give R1 and R2 and C. We have to find the T on and T off values. That same thing which we had learnt in lab, the T on's formula will be this, T off formula will be this, R1 and R2 and C which they have given here. If C they have not given, I guess we can take as 0.01 microfarad, that's the default value, and I think so, I'm not sure, but let's confirm and say. So applying these values, applying the values, we get the final answer, and it looks good to make a box, and it will look easier for the teacher also to correct your paper. And the final answer is 18 millisecond and 10.395 millisecond we got for T on and T off. Coming to the second type of question, most of the questions are asked in this way, to find T on and T off, or they can ask to find the frequency and the duty cycle. Frequency and duty cycle have their formulas on, which is see this one, F is equal to 1 by T. The frequency is 1 by time period. Time period can be written in terms of RA and 2 RA, RB and C. Okay, time period can be written RA plus 2RB, the whole multiplied by C. So applying the values, we will get, we have been given by RA, RB and C. Okay, so we can apply that and find the value of F. In duty cycle, the formula is this, and we can apply the formula and find the value of these two. So yeah, finally we get these two answers as 10.357 kHz and DC value as, duty cycle value as 66.66%. See, DC means T on by T off, or something else, I guess, I'm not sure. It's actually T on by T. T means total time taken. Duty cycle is given by T on by T. In some questions they give as duty cycle as 75%, so we have to write T on by T is equal to 75%, and 75% we can write as 3/4. Then from that we have to calculate. And another thing which you need to remember is if they don't give the RA or RB value, we have to consider RA or RB as 10, either of that as 10. We have to guess, we have to take and find the general equation. And but those questions are not asked much. The most questions are asked this type or this type only. So that completes the A-stable multivibrator. So next topic which we are gonna solve the numerical on is Smith trigger. It's very very important topic. Most questions have been asked in the Smith trigger each year, and it's not that hard. Three formulas are there for UTP, LTP and V hysteresis. And by using that we can solve any of this Smith trigger type question. And for Smith trigger, both non-inverting and inverting, those both have same formulas. So in the question we have been given VSAT, UTP and LTP. We have to find R1 and R2. Whenever they say design a Smith trigger circuit, we have to find R1 and R2 first. Okay, so the formula for UTP and LTP is same, just VSAT will be positive here and VSAT will be negative here. So when we subtract this negative and this negative will become positive, so it will be 2 VSAT R2 by R1 plus R2. Applying the values, we get the equation R1 is equal to 13 R2. See, UTP and LTP here it will come 2, and this 28 R2 by R1 plus R2. Simplify and we'll get R1 is equal to 13 R2. Let R2 is equal to 10 kilo ohm. See, like this only, when we get any equation, we have to take R2 as 10 kilo ohm. Remember that one. R2 as 10 kilo ohm, if we take R1 is equal to 13 into 10, 130 kilo ohm. So we got the values of R1 and R2, and that's what we need for the question. Designing means we have to make that circuit diagram which I had discussed in the theory part, and we have to mention the values of R1 as that and R2 as that particularly. And this question is also the similar thing. Design a Smith trigger and the UTP and LTP values have been given, and VSAT is also given. We have to find here V reference is a new thing. See, R1 and R2 we can find out as the previous question, same R1 and R2 will get. But what is V reference? What is that formula for it? See, here I will tell you the formula for it. So applying the values of UTP and LTP and the we get the V and after applying the V saturation value, we get the equation for R1 and R2. We take R2 as 10 kilo ohm as in the previous question, and we get R1, and we have R1 and R2 and UTP, LTP, and this all things we have. When we apply all these things here, we get V reference as 3.27 volt, and that's what the question asks us to solve. And after finding this, we have to design a Smith trigger, means at last we have to make that circuit diagram. So moving on, we have the next topic as filters. Filters is very very easy, and in filters you just have to remember two things. In most of the questions they ask this thing only. They'll give the value of F and C. You have to find R and AF. AF means the gain in the frequency. So for first order I'll solve one question, and for the second order I'll solve one question. That applies same for all the high pass, low pass and wide band reject, wide band pass filter, all have the same formulas. I'll like explain it with this example, and I hope this should be sufficient for you to solve any type of this question from the filters. So let's get started. They have given FH and C, and we have to find R and AF. So let's write the formulas for R as well as AF. So the formula of F is 1 by 2 pi RC. So R will be 1 by 2 pi FC. When we apply all the formulas, apply all the values to it, we get the answer as 7.233 kilo ohms. And for AF, actually we have been given in the question AF, that is 2. So we have been given this. What we need to find actually is RF and R1. RF and R1 will be, according to this formula, RF by R1 is, when it gets shifted to here, RF by R1 and R1 is 1. So RF is equal to R1 is equal to 10 kilo ohms. So the value, when we don't have any value, we always take it as 10 kilo ohm as default for assumption. RF is equal to R1 is equal to 10 kilo ohm. So coming to the second order, what we have here is, yeah, this is the second order. Second order filter is also the same, but it has R3 and R2 also. So the same formula we are gonna apply, but omega is here, so first we need to convert omega into frequency. So first thing, we'll convert omega into 2 pi f. Omega into f, we'll find out the value. F is equal to omega by 2 pi. So omega by 2 pi, we'll apply the values and we'll get 2.3870 kilohertz. And that is the value of f. So we'll write the formula of fh. fh is equal to 1 by 2 pi r2 r3 c2 c3. See, in the previous question, there was only r, so it was rr cc, r square c square square root rc was there, 1 by 2 pi rc. But here also it is same only, in most of the questions it is same. And if they ask any different, they may give the values. I guess they will give the values of r2, r3, so we have to apply that. But in this case, they have not given anything, so we have considered it as same. And c, we have to consider as 0.01 if they have not given anything. But in this question, they have given. If they don't give, we have to consider this value. So applying this fh, we have this here and we have everything here, given only r is not there, so we'll shift the r and find r. R2 is equal to r3 is equal to 6.67 kilo ohms. So like this, we'll find the value of r2 and r3, and that's what the question had asked, determine the value of resistances required. Okay, the filters, I guess it's the easiest topic in the module, the both the numerical and theory part. It's just lengthy, but when you simplify the things, it's very easier. So the next thing which we have is regulator. Regulator means when we have the analog signal, we have to convert it into a DC signal. So we are using regulator, and in between that, many things are there, like which will filter everything and make a rectifier, that all things, and transformer, that all things will help in regulating a DC voltage. So in the exam point of view, you have three things: line regulation, load regulation, and ripple rejection factor. So in this question, they have been asked us to find the better one. And what they have given two power supplies. A has no load and full load as this one. So this is no load and this is full load. B has this no load and full load. Most of the questions asked from the regulator are either of these three types. So what they are asking, we have to find the voltage regulation. So find the better one. Actually, what's voltage regulation? It's actually the change in the output when input gets changed. So obviously we don't want the output to change more when the input gets changed. So the output doesn't get changed more, that's better one. So the voltage regulation which is less, that's better one. I hope you got that. And two power supplies. So first one, I'll write the answer first. Okay, so when we calculate by applying the values of no load and full load, we observe that B's voltage regulation is less in percentage than voltage regulation of A. So what happens is the change in the output of B is very less as compared to the change in the input output in A. So output in A gets changed more and output in B gets changed less for the same amount of change in the input. So B is better one than A. So this is the next question. In this question, we have been given the power supply values of no load and full load, and we have to find the line regulation and load regulation. Line regulation is the change in the output divided by the input, what is the value. So what change they have given? Plus or minus 0.5. so we will calculate plus 0.5, then minus 0.5, then the change in the output is 0.5 divided by what is the input, it's 24 into 100, will get as 4.17. for load regulation, we have to find the no load and full load. The voltage changes from no load to full load from 24 to 23. So no load minus full load is 24 minus 23.8 divided by 23.8 into 100%, that will get as 0.84%. so that's a pretty good question, and the exam type of question comes similar to it. And this is the ripple rejection question. In this question, they will give RR, or they will give these both. You have to find RR. And another thing, they will either give in decibel or not decibel, that we have to find out. If they are given decibel, then we have to use the log. If they don't give, we have to not use the log, only just this thing. Okay, so V ripple input is 2 volts and V ripple output we have to find. So 20 log VR by VR out is equal to RR. What is RR here? They have given as minus 80 decibel. So cancelling this both at the both sides, what we get here is 4. So log of VR input is 2 by V output is equal to minus 4. Okay, then after solving it, we'll get V output as, okay, first let's see how to solve the log part. Log base 10, if nothing is given, it's base 10, and we have been given this, and this value is here. So how to solve this? The general formula is log base a and b is equal to x, then a raised to x is equal to b. So in this case, b is this, a is this, and x is this. So a raised to x, what is a here? A is n. So 10 raised to minus 4 is equal to b. What is b? 2 by v0. Now you can solve, right? V0 is equal to, we get 0.2 millivolt, and that's it. The question for ripple rejection type. These three questions come from regulator topic, and the last thing left is digital to analog converter. So before moving on to the last topic, I would like to say the important formulas here used here. Its resolution is 2 raised to n, and least significant bit is 1 by 2 raised to n, and VOFS is full scale output or maximum voltage, VO is output voltage, and resolution can also be written as V offset by 2 raised to n minus 1. V offset means the full scale output voltage, and V0 can be written as resolution into B. Okay, where B is the binary code, like 110101, like that. So let's start the questions. Now see, they have been given, we have been given what are the percentage and voltage resolution of 9B DAC given that V offset is 5 volts. 9-bit DAC, 9-bit means N is 9. The bit number is 9, so the resolution can be 2 raised to 9. So we have to find, we have been given as V offset, full scale voltage is 5 volt. We have to find the percentage regulation as well as voltage regulation. So let's see which formula we need to apply to find out the answer. Yeah, the formulas which we use are 1 by 2 raised to n into 100%, that's for resolution, we get 0.2%, and for voltage regulation, voltage resolution, we use 1 by 2 raised to n into 5 volt. 5 volt is the maximum offset voltage, so we get as 10 millivolt. Okay, this is one type of question, and there are three more questions from which the types the questions can be asked. So we have been given with the offset voltage, what is there? A 4-bit DAC, 0111, this is the decimal, no, not decimal, it's binary. The binary equivalent, the decimal equivalent is 7 of this, and we have to find the output voltage, VO. VO formula is resolution into D. Resolution is V offset by 2 raised to n minus 1. Okay, V offset we have been given as 15, 2 raised to n minus 1 is also 15, so 15 by 15, resolution is 1. Resolution is 1, and they have given 4-bit DAC, so n is 2 here, n is 4 actually, 4. Okay, so VO is equal to 1 resolution into D. What is D? It's 7, so the answer is 7. That's it. Okay, so moving on to the next question. This is the second last question, and we have been given an 8-bit DAC, this is n, and resolution we have been given 22 millivolt. Calculate the V offs, means maximum voltage, and output. If the input is this, so this is D is this one, and we have to find out the equivalent of this, and we have to as well find VO and V offset. So let's see which formula we need to apply and how to find it. So the formula which we use is resolution is equal to V offset by 2 raised to n minus 1. So we are having the value of 2 raised to n minus 1 as well as resolution. So cross multiplying, we get the value of V offset, which is 5.6 volt. This is the first part of the question. The second part is V naught, V out, output. First, we will calculate the decimal equivalent of the binary number, which we get as 128, and we are applying that as V output is equal to resolution into D. D is 128 and resolution is 22 millivolt. So finally we get as 2.8 volt, that's the output voltage. So coming to the last question, this last question we have to find out the R to R ladder type question, in which R and RF values have been same, so it has been excluded in this. It's V reference here, and RF and R values were there in theory part, right? So this is same, so it's excluded here. They have not given anything. Most of the questions it's same. So we are applying this formula and finding out the value of 10 to analog, and 0.0011 also to analog. Given V reference, we have been given as 10 volt. So we are applying here 10 volt, and we are applying these values here. So let's see how it works. So we apply this formula here, bn. What is bn? The maximum number of bit. In this 10, we have what's the maximum number of bit? It's 1. So 2 raised to minus 1 into b1 plus 2 raised to minus 2 into b0. When we reach b0, we have to stop. So we are applying the values of b1 and b0 as given in the question. So here 10 into b1 is 1 by 2 plus 2 square is 4, down it will come 4, b0 is 0. So when we simplify this, 10 into 1 by 2 is equal to 5 volts. We get 5 volts. Similarly, we have to apply for this also, 0011. In here, 4 bits are there, okay? Now let's see how to solve this one. So first up, what you need to write down is, you have to write down the values of b1, b0, b1, b2 and b3. So we'll know what is b1, b2 and b3. And then apply the formula. And in that formula, what is the maximum bit here? B3. So we'll write here 2 raised to minus 1 into B3, then B2, B1, B0, and apply the values and calculate the answer. So that ends the numerical part of this AED module 1. I hope so it helped you. And thanks a lot for watching this video. And if you have any doubts, you can please feel free to contact me. Again, thanks a lot for watching this video. Bye.